Watching CGTN live streaming from Shenyang Palace Museum in China's northeast Liaoning province. The palace is one of the only two imperial buildings for Qing Dynasty in China, second to the Forbidden City in Beijing. And the palace has a history of about 400 years, and it was listed in the UNESCO World Heritage. As the Spring Festival is around the corner, and as we know, eating dumplings is a proud tradition for Northeast Chinese people. And today we will be joining a group of children learning how to make dumplings in the palace. And later on, I will be joined by an expert telling the stories and traditions behind the dumpling eating tradition of China, in ancient China. Now let's go inside and check out what the children are doing for the dumplings. Now we can see children are sitting there, cleaning their hands. So today, skilled workers from Lao Bian Dumpling House is intangible cultural heritage in Northeast China, and they will teach the children how to make very classic dumplings. We can check out the room. Is decorated by Qing Dynasty paintings, like this one. We can see it. The activities holding in the palace in Qing Dynasty. And classic costumes for Manchu minority. And the teachers are making introduction to children.
那这个沈阳故宫我们都知道这是什么地方是一个大的皇宫对吧皇宫里面住的是谁是皇帝是不是那我又有新的问题了这个腊八节的时候我们吃什么腊八粥那这个立春的时候我们吃什么
饺子
立春的时候吃春饼对不对那个俗话说得好民以食为天
我们这个过节的时候啊，每个不同的节气、不同的节日，我们都吃非常有代表性的这个食物来庆祝这个节日，对不对？对。那马上就要过圣诞节了。
Teachers are preparing flowers, the doughs for later on.
那新年的时候我们要吃什么呢？饺子，饺子象征着什么？吉祥。
A teacher is saying the dumplings symbolize lucky and wealth.
饺子就是饺子了，这个饺子啊。 在清朝以前的时候，皇帝怎么样？他们也是吃饺子的，但他们吃的饺子跟咱们现在的都不一样了。我们现在包好怎么样？直接就煮着吃了，对吧？在以前的时候，他们在十二月份，农历的十二月份，也就是腊月的时候，把这个饺子包好了，然后冻在外边，等到正月新年那一月的时候。
Teachers are telling the students stories about the dumplings traditional dumpling eating in Spring Festival. So we'll go outside and meet the expert to tell us the story behind it. Let's go. 张老师您好。 this is Zhang Guobin, assistant research fellow at Shenyang Palace Museum. He will give us a tour of the palace and tell us the story behind it.
张老师您好，您给我们讲一下这个吃饺子清宫里面吃饺子的历史吧。好的。在清代宫廷的时候，他们也非常重视除夕吃饺子这个习俗。历代皇帝不仅重视饺子的馅儿，还有吃饺子的仪式。
以表示他们那个不忘咱们沈阳这块发现之地的这个表现。
So in Qing Dynasty, the emperors attach great importance to eating dumplings. It represents and symbolizes to memorize the tradition and history of their originated area. This is the place Qing or Manchu minority emperor start their career. Right.
在侵入关以前就留下了一条不成文的规定，就是侵公在出席吃的这顿饺子，它必须是素馅的。
There's an written rule in Qing Dynasty before it went into Beijing to conquer the great land of the China's territory. The Qing Dynasty, the Qing Palace, emperors must eat vegetarian filling dumplings.
他们吃这个素馅主要是以干素菜为主，像马齿苋、金针菜、木耳，然后辅以一些素三鲜，比如是蘑菇、干豆腐干，还有鸡蛋这些。I
heard. The fillings of dumplings eaten by the emperor must be vegetarian, including some herbs and fungus, mushroom, bamboo shoots, gluten, dried tofu, and even fried eggs.
到了除夕这天晚上，就是他们先举行这个瞻拜礼仪。皇帝举行完礼仪之后，他就要到这个。
There's a group of tourists joining us in the palace, so we'll move to another place, a quieter place.
就是每到除夕的时候，皇帝先在清宫举行瞻拜礼仪，举行完礼仪以后，他就会到这个乾清宫左侧的昭仁殿东小屋吃饺子。
There's a usual ritual for the emperor eating dumplings in the New Year's Eve, in Lunar New Year's Eve, and the place, the location for eating dumplings is also regulated strictly. He has to eat the dumplings in the Zhaorun Hall beside the.
乾清
Palace. Qianqing Palace is the place where is the emperor's residence, where the emperor eat and live, right? Live and work.
Yes. 当皇帝迈上乾清宫的台阶时候，御膳房就开始煮饺子。等到皇帝到了昭仁殿这个吃饺子的案子前做好以后，御膳房就把这个煮好的饺子给端到的桌前。
As soon as the emperor step out downward the Qianqing Palace, the chef in the imperial kitchen will put the dumplings into boiled water to make sure the emperor can eat the fresh out of port dumplings when he sit tight in front of the desk.
但是，怎么确保这个厨房跟那个厨房下饺子的时间非常准确呢？能保证那个皇帝在坐下的时候就能吃到那个刚出锅的饺子？因为在清宫嘛，他这个正月的时候，就是皇帝每过一道门槛，随侍的太监他就会放一挂鞭炮，这样御膳房听到鞭炮响的时候，他就能准确的把握这个时间，还有这个每一步皇帝到哪儿了，他该怎么做了。
So there's a very good way of communication in Qing Dynasty. Whenever the emperor step out threshold in the palace, the eunuch accompanied by the emperor will set off firecrackers. So the chef in the imperial kitchen will get the notice and he will start cooking to make sure the timing is perfect for the emperor to eat.
然后除夕这顿饺子吧，它不只是吃饺子这个就是合家团圆这件事儿，就是美好的意思，还有一个就是一个礼仪性的活动。
Eating dumplings in Spring Festival in the in Lunar China's New Year's Eve is not only a is not only a
这是个合家团圆的
It's not a family gathering event. It's also a ceremony. It's also a ritual event, right?
对，也是一些礼仪。然后，像乾隆皇帝他就是我们档案记载，他吃饺子就是给他煮了四个饺子，里边有两个是包着铜钱，就是有两个是什么都没有的素馅饺子。然后那天乾隆皇帝特别的幸运，他就是两个馅带钱的饺子，他都吃完了，然后又吃了一个没有的饺子，一共吃了三个饺子。
According to the document, the Emperor Qianlong, in which year, 哪一年, 这个是发生在哪一年的时候?
1783年。乾隆48年。
乾隆48年。 In the 48th year under Emperor Qianlong's reign, the imperial kitchen prepared four dumplings. Two of them contained coins in the dumplings, in the filling of the dumplings. So the coin in the dumpling means wealthy. Whoever eats the dumplings with coins means lucky in the coming year. And among the four dumplings prepared for Qianlong, he ate three of them, and two of them are included by the coin. So he is considered very lucky in their year, in that year.
对，所以就是我们东北现在仍然过年的时候有这项习俗，就是老百姓家包饺子的时候，也有一些饺子里包上钱，谁吃到了就表示谁今年特别的幸运。
So the tradition passed along by the years, and in Northeast China, people in households are still using this tradition to stuff coins inside dumplings. Whoever eats it will be considered very lucky in the coming year.
然后这个吃饺子的仪式到了嘉庆的时候吧，又稍微有个调整，就是我们在清宫档案里有一个记载，嘉庆四年吃饺子的。 这个过程和他这个吃饺子的这些使用器具记载特别的详细。
The tradition has a little bit changed during the Emperor Jiaqing. And in the document, there is a very specific recording about the tableware, the tools he used, the Emperor Jiaqing used during the Spring Festival. He eats when he eats the dumplings.
首先咱们说一说嘉庆帝吃饺子这个用的这个大案，叫做大吉案。它是一个木台的黑色雕漆的，然后描金的，有吉祥纹饰的一个大案子。So
the dinner table for Emperor Jiaqing to eat dumplings is a black wooden made table, and there's gold inlaid, the gold decoration inlaid on the table.
在他这个桌案的四面这个四周吧，它有那个葫芦旺带的图案。葫芦其实它谐音是福禄，旺带就表示这个长寿的意思。葫芦旺带。
So the decorations supposed to mean lucky and wealthy and happy. means this all blessing words for the emperor, right?
然后在葫芦的正中嘛，它有一些就是表示吉祥的词语，比如说“一人有庆”，这个是皇帝他的专用的。然后有那个。甲子重新，然后旺过咸宁，还有吉祥如意这些意思，就是前面三个词语的意思吧，就是表示这个皇帝他那个对于老百姓这个职责，然后最后一个吧，就是一个吉祥美好的意思。
Okay, so there are lucky sentences printed on the table as well. Including four sentences, 一人有庆 means the emperor is very wise. And 万国咸宁 means the people live happily in the country. And
甲子重新
means a new airport starts. 吉祥如意 means good luck.
然后在这个 案子上还有这个吉字, 就是吉祥的吉字。
吉 means luck in Chinese, and there's this character printed on the table as well.
家庭地吃饺子吧, 还有四个辅助的碟, 然后它碟里放的是酱小菜和囊小菜, 还有姜汁儿, 醋, 这是蘸料。
是不是有一个房间展示了这些就是清宫里面吃饺子清宫里面饮食的一些用具我们可以去那个房间看一下后宫生活长里头是这边还是那边我们可以进去看一下具体的清宫器具咱们可以一起看看 So the Mr. Zhang tell me there are four plates prepared for Emperor Jiaqing to use dumplings. On the inside, the place containing four different kinds of food, including the sauce, vinegar for dumpling, and the southern flavored dishes, as well as pickles, and the last one is 是姜汁是吧？姜汁是 ginger juice.
然后这四个碟吧，他就放在刚才说那四个就是成语那个字儿上。
And the four plates will put placed right on the four lucky sentences printed on the table.
在靠近皇帝宝座这个的图案上吧，放着皇帝吃饺子用的这个金象牙的筷子，然后金勺、金叉、擦手布，还有这个。 土堂用的这个渣豆
So on the side of where the emperor sits on the side of the table where the emperor sits they will place the tableware for the emperor to eat the dumplings including ivory chopsticks golden forks and golden 是金叉，还有金勺 and golden spoon, as well as hand towel and sweet container. We can see the bowls using in the Qing Dynasty. The royal family used this tablewares to have their meal.
请我们这个不用了，不用了，话筒不用了，说吧。这些碗，这些我们展出的这个碗，就是清代宫廷生活里头用的一些餐具。它上面的图案有龙纹，还有一些花卉纹，缠着花卉纹，上面也写了一些寿字匾。
So the tablewares for royal family are all decorated by patterns like dragon and flowers.
然后像这一组是过寿的时候用的，这个黄色地儿的盘子上面写着“万寿无疆”，就是长寿的意思。然后像这边这个粉彩瓜碟盘，这个蝴蝶，还有上面的瓜碟鲶鲶，那个也都是表示这个长寿的，就是我们。 清代乾隆年间，重庆皇太后八旬万寿图上就有这两个。
The place, the characters on the place means long live, live forever. And the butterfly pattern on this plate also means living long, has a longevity experience, life experience. And the place were used for birthday party for rural for royal members.
Then this is 唾盂，就是吐痰吐口水用的。就刚才咱们嘉庆帝吃饺子的时候，他边上也放一个扎斗，就类似这样的一个器具。
Okay,
This is a spitten, a spit container, for the emperor to wash their mouth after eating.
When
the Jiaqing is also recorded in the documentary about the Emperor Jiaqing, the ceremony Emperor Jiaqing eating dumplings during the Spring Festival, when he sit down tight, the chief eunuch will kneel in front of him, holding a tray decorated delicately. And there are two porcelain bowls on the tray containing dumplings.
另一只碗盛放两个铜钱，嘉庆铜宝还有乾隆铜宝。
The two bowls on the tray, one of them containing six vegetarian dumplings. The other one contains two coins, one called 嘉庆 coin, the other one is 乾隆 coin.
因为嘉庆四年的时候吧，乾隆皇帝他还在世，他是太上皇，所以用了嘉庆铜宝和乾隆铜宝两个。
Because when Jiaqing took the crown, the fourth year when Jiaqing took the crown, his father Qianlong was still alive, and so they put two kinds of coins on the table, right?
然后这个首领太监先把盛放素馅饺子的碗放到那个大案子上边。
And the chief eunuch will put the bowl containing dumplings on the table.
然后请嘉庆帝，就是他有一个类似于咱们这个恭请的动作，然后就是说请，他当时叫万岁爷，然后使用主角。
The eunuch will say something to the emperor like, the long live Lord, please use the boiled dumplings.
然后嘉庆帝才开始，就是拿着筷子开始吃这个素馅饺子。
Then after what the eunuch said, the emperor would start using the dumplings.
一般来说，皇帝就是这些饺子不会全部吃完，他会剩一个两个的，然后把这个剩的饺子吧，他就给供起来。
Usually the emperor would not finish all the dumplings the kitchen provided, so the left dumplings will be offered to the Buddhist god.
不一定是神，就是也可能是祖先。
The Buddhist or the ancestors will be offered to them as a ritual, right?
就是一个礼仪，是一个传统礼仪。对，因为到现在来说，北方一些地方也有这个吃饺子的时候给自己的祖先来一份，然后这个也是他那个不忘祖先的一个意思。
So even in northern part of China, people will make some extra dumplings specifically to remembering the ancestors, offering the ancestors. It's a kind of tradition in northern China.
除夕这顿饺子基本都是素馅的。但是到了清代晚期以后吧，就是随着这个时代的变迁，还有他们的这个祖宗遗训的这个，就是可能不那么坚守。除夕的素馅饺子有的也都成了肉馅的。然后吃饺子的位置，就是他们吃饭的地方，也有一些变化。
So for the first few emperors in Qing Dynasty, they stick with the tradition very strictly. So they eat only vegetarian dumplings. But later at the end of the imperial Qing imperial area, the emperor started to eat
pork mix filling dumplings.
比如说光绪皇帝他吃饺子的地方就变到了这个养心殿。
And the locations changed as well. For example, Emperor Guangxu eat dumplings in Yangxin Hall instead of Zhaoren Hall for his ancestors, right?
然后它这个肉馅吧，一般都是有鸡肉或者说是猪肉这样的，配一些蔬菜。
For the fillings of the dumplings, usually they take chickens and pork fillings, dumplings, with some vegetables.
事实上吧，在清宫它，主要是除夕这一顿是素馅的，在正月里它还是会吃些肉馅饺子。
In Qing Dynasty, the emperor or the royal family, the first meal of dumplings, they eat vegetarian fillings, dumplings. But for the other meals at the start of the year, they can eat something with pork, with meat.
我们在清宫这个乾隆时期的这个上食档的正月档里，它就有记载了一些乾隆皇帝正月里吃的肉馅饺子。
Okay, there's a document recording Emperor Qianlong, what he ate during the Spring Festival. Here we can see what is the food. This is the food. This is
the food. This is the food. This is the food. This is the food. This is the food. This is the
food. We can go. We can go to the building. 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 We can go to the building.好像有一些特殊的是关于吃饺子的传统。
对，在入关之前吧，就咱们可以先看看今天这下雪了，我们特别的冷。在清入关之前，东北的气候比现在还要冷，所以他们入关之前吃饺子吧，有一些就是特别有意思的事情。
Before the emperor move into Beijing, they still live in this palace in a northern part of China because the weather is very cold in the region in winter. So there's something very interesting about dumpling eating at that period.
就是在入关前吧，他出席那天包了特别特别多的饺子，然后出席这一顿吃的是用
So the kitchen prepared a lot of dumplings before the Spring Festival, and they ate some of them for in the Spring Fest in the Lunar New Year's Eve, and they storage them outside. Because the weather is very cold, the outside is a natural refrigerator. So they frozen the dumplings for later use.
然后在正月里边，咱们在每天慢慢的吃这些包着粽子的饺子，以表示吃隔年饭，就是表示家里有余粮。
This has a very good meaning for the for ancient Chinese. They storage some food because they are rich, they are wealthy, they can have some extra food in the coming year.
对，我们现在又有一个成语，就是年年有余，基本上也就是相同的意思。
年年有余 ，like there's always left over, there's always something left.
然后就是包饺子的这个形状吧，其实当时和现在也都差不多。很多饺子它包成这种元宝形的，就是表示这个收获财宝的一个美好寓意。
So the shape of the dumplings, are like the traditional Chinese, like metal ingot. They are the currency of in ancient China. So the shape of the dumpling, why people eat it, is also because they symbolize wealthy.
然后还有一些别的形状，比如说像柳叶形的。
柳叶形 ，like leaves on the.
然后这个饺子有煮的，还有蒸的，就是我们档案记载里有一些饺子它是烫面的，就是我们现在老百姓家做蒸饺也还是用烫面的。我们今天这个活动它包的饺子就是这个蒸饺。
Okay, so there's different kind of shapes for dumplings. Also, the different kind of cooking. Cooking as well. They can boil the dumplings, they can steam the dumplings. There are many ways of eating dumplings. I think today we have a very informative tour inside the palace, and that's pretty much from me for now. And this is the event you're watching CGTN live streaming in Shenyang Palace Museum. Today we have an event making dumplings inside the building, inside the palace. And Mr. Zhang has given us a very good lecture, informative lecture about the history of Qing Dynasty, the emperors, how emperors eat dumplings, and the tradition passed along for more than northern Chinese people. So we're pretty much all from here in Shenyang. See you next time. Thank you. Thanks for watching.